Greetings to you in the precious name of the Lord Jesus Christ. This is Brother Martin Mallette, and I am coming to you with Romania Mission in Romania in Eastern Europe. We're in Bucharest, Romania right today. And some of you have asked me some questions, and I want to answer them to you. And first, I want to thank you, all you that pray for us, all you that help us and support us, and that are part of this team, part of the mission team here in Romania. We're called Romania Mission, but our home base is located in Pigeon Forge, Tennessee, and we have some of our brothers there that work with us and help us. And I want to thank you very much for sending the baptistry, the money for our baptistry. We have two brothers who are pastors there at in Kodak at the Crossing, and I just want to let you know that I love you so much in the Lord, and we thank you for buying us a baptistry so we can baptize folks over here, because it's still cold. If you look, I have a hat and a big, it's cold, amen. There's still some snow out there. And so, but now we can baptize people. But some of you ask me, Brother Martin, why should I be involved in Romania missions? Why should I get involved in any missionaries or evangelizing the world? I want to give you just a few reasons. But before I do that, I'm going to read a scripture to you and ask you if you know this scripture. Most of you know it by heart, but maybe not in context. Listen to what it says in Philippians chapter 4 and in verses 19, I think it is. Let me turn there. 19, yes. But my God shall supply all your need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Now, many times we quote that for ourselves, and you can apply it to yourself. Well, let's look at it in its context just for a moment. Paul is talking to the church at Philippi, and for those that have brought him gifts and things to help him get the gospel out to other churches. You remember Epaphroditus came and he brought some gifts from Thessalonica, the church there, to help him to spread the gospel. And that's the way the gospel goes out. You say, well, Brother Martin, how are you doing now with this pandemic going on? Are you going to come back to America? I don't know that I can come back to America without taking the vaccination. And I'm not too hip on that, if you understand what I'm talking about. You say, well, you shouldn't have worried. Listen, that's something else. Whether I can come or not, I don't know. I don't think so right now. And I may never come back to America. Who knows? But what's important is, what is God's will for your life and my life right now? Not to get depressed, not to get oppressed or depressed by some of the stuff that's going on in America and some of the things that the political leaders are doing. But think, we have a responsibility and a privilege and a joy to give the gospel out, amen, to go ye in all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Now, this is one of the reasons why you need to get involved. It was the last words our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ spoke before he went back up into heaven. He said these words. He said, all power is given to me in heaven and in earth. And then he said, go ye therefore in all nations, teaching them to observe all things. You remember that's in Matthew chapter 28 and in verses 19. But he also says, it's in Mark 16, he said, go ye in all the world and preach the gospel. So it's God's will that we go out into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. And then another reason it's good is because of what Jesus Christ has done for you. That's another reason you get involved. If you're saved and born again, the joy of the Lord that's in your heart and the joy and the love for others to know the Lord Jesus Christ. When God called me to Romania, I wasn't thinking about coming to Romania. I just happened to see a newspaper ad or a newspaper article about the revolution. And I seen those people standing and said, the communist curtain has fallen. The socialism and communism has fallen. And now the gospel is free to get in there. Or I just seen that part, that it was had the freedom. So I came to Romania in 1991 in January and started. Amen. Because it was God's will for me, not Africa, not India, not Japan, but Romania. That's what God called me to. And then another reason we ought to get involved in it, and I never ask lost people to do this. I only speak to those that know the Lord Jesus Christ, you that are born again. Listen, it's God's will for you to do it. Amen. It's good. God's will for you to get the gospel out. Because, and I never tell lost people that, because I don't want them to think they're working for their salvation. I do it because of a love in my heart. I'm not trying to earn crowns. I will get some crowns by the grace of God. And there will be an abundant entrance according to 2 Peter chapter 1. I know that. But because I studied God's word, I read it in there, and it said that. But that's not the reason I'm serving the Lord. I'm serving the Lord, but one day he saved me by his grace. And he came in my heart to live in my life. And he lives in me and he speaks to me. Like that song says, and you remember the song in the garden? I come to the garden alone while the dew still on the roses. And you remember the chorus? And he walks with me and he talks with me and he tells me that I'm his own. That's the reason I'm here. Is because God the Father has sent his son Jesus and he's given us the Holy Spirit to live in us and to lead us and to guide us in all truth. And for the joy of the Lord, God is living in me. And for the joy of the Heavenly Father. You think about this. You remember what God said, the Lord was saying there in Luke? He said in Luke chapter 15 about the prodigal son that went from, left home when he come back. But before that, he said there's joy in heaven in the presence of God's angels. Didn't say the angels had the joy. It's the Father that has the joy over one sinner that repenteth. And just think about that. We lead somebody to Christ. Every time somebody comes into the family of God, they're in the member in the bride of Christ, a part of Jesus Christ's body that he's died for, and he loves them. Amen? And he wants you to go to them, wherever they're at. If you can't support us here in Mission, Romania Mission, find somebody somewhere that's preaching the gospel and getting it out and not building bigger houses and bigger church buildings and bigger gymnasiums and buying airplanes and other stuff. But somebody's getting the gospel out to the people, reaching the people for Christ. And it's such a joy when we can go into a place and never heard the gospel before and preach the gospel and watch people start crying and getting and want to get saved. They said, we didn't know this. We didn't know that we could get saved, that Jesus Christ. We knew that he was the Son of God, but we never knew that he came to save us from our sins and to come to live within us and to give us eternal life. What a joy. That's the greatest joy I know of. Amen. And then another reason we need to, because one day we'll win a crown. Remember the Apostle Paul said in chapter 4, Philippians in chapter 1, he said that they were his joy and crown of rejoicing. And God wants you to win folks to Christ because it's God's will. And one day, according to 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 10, we're all going to stand before the judgment seat of Christ to give an account. Now, I'm not trying to scare you into doing anything. God bless your heart if it's not in your heart to get involved in your responsibility of in missions, evangelizing the world. He told you to do it. It's his will. Amen. What you do with that, that's your business. And who you want to support. But you need to find somebody you can get involved with that's getting the gospel out. Some missionary somewhere in some part of this earth that's getting the gospel out. And you said, I want to help them get the gospel out. It's God's will that we get the gospel. What a joy it is. We want to send you some pictures and show you some things that are going on here. God bless you. We have our address. You can see where we're at and how you can help us and how you can pray for us and get involved in this work. Thank you so much. You say, Brother Martin, are you coming back to America? I wish, I hope, and I pray that one day God will open the door and let me come back and go around some of the churches I used to go to. You know, I have a brother that when I get home, I say home, that's home. America is my home. When I get there, he gives me a place to stay. He's my dear brother. And he says, Brother Martin, he said, where do you want to eat at? You want to eat at the steakhouse? You want to go to the Red Lobster? You know, I said, Brother, you know, I don't know how to eat in these places anymore. I don't even know what's good. He said, oh, you know what's good? Do you want to eat Mexican? I'm going, I don't have all these varieties to eat here. Of course, I don't know if you have that anymore in America either, but he's such a loving brother, and he's been such a blessing to me in the work here. It's Dennis Maples, if you know who it is, and he's the one that sends you out a tax-deductible receipt from the gifts that you send through the post office there at Pigeon Forge. And he's a dear brother. He's a dear, dear brother. And then I have another brother there that every time I get to America and get to Pigeon Forge, he owns a dealership at Volunteer Chevrolet. And his name is Gary Hilton. And he always gives me a free car to drive. And one day he gave me a nice car to use to travel to different churches. Most of you know me, you know that. And I was praying, I said, Lord, I got this good car, but I don't have any money for gas. You know, there's not a cash flow here like it is in the States. You have a cash flow, maybe. But I was praying, I said, oh, Lord, what in the world am I going to do for gas? And a brother called me up, and he's such a dear brother. He owns a gift shop, the biggest gift shop, I guess, in that part of the country. And he's such a loving brother. His name is Brother Bill. He said, "Brother Martin, I got a card here for gas, a credit card that you can get gas all over the country." And he gave me a card to use. You see, that's the way God supplies our needs. I'm not begging for money. You know, I'm not. I'm really not. But I'd like for you to get involved somewhere and get the joy of the Lord of getting the gospel out and seeing other people get saved. Planting New Testament churches. That's what we do here. In Jesus' name, God bless you. Amen.